month, and I headed all the way. Thanks for the hearts, guys, by the way. And hi, Yoshi. Hi, Ground Floor Entrepreneur. Hi, Kessel. Hi, Butterflies. Hi, Peace, Love, Rock On. Hi, Christian. Hi, Cherise. Hi, Viviana. Hi, Luna. Hi, 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 guys. Thanks so much for joining me. So excited to be with you today. So what I'm going to be talking to you about today is my two latest blog posts. You will find them linked. And what I'm going to be sharing with you is where I got my certification. So I got certified as many different things, a life and success coach, a NLP practitioner, a hypnotherapist, emotional freedom techniques, that's tapping, and time techniques, which is pretty much like a sped up version of NLP. So I want to share with you where I got certified, how I did the certification, everything that I learned, how it's bringing me some really, really cool, interesting clients, and I'm helping them with really cool, interesting things. And then I did not get my own health coaching certification because I'm not a health coach, but I also just wrote a blog post for people who are wanting to become a health coach and they want to get certified and they're wondering, you know, what's a good place to get certified. So you can literally head to yosupply.co and read the blog post and all the information is there. So about, thanks so much for joining. There's so many people in here. It's so awesome. So about a month ago, I went to California and I went to the OC. And if anyone knows me, I'm from Toronto. I'm from Canada. And so it's a little bit of a journey for me, but I am obsessed with California. I am obsessed with palm trees, so I didn't really need that much of an excuse to go. And I was heading to Europe anyway, so I'm like, why not just do a whole month of traveling, whatever. So I went to a company called Transform Destiny. I had done a lot of research before. I had been interested in NLP ever since I discovered Tony Robbins, and I was always reading books on NLP, and Tony Robbins has a book all about NLP, and always just like looking up tactics and stuff online, and kind of just like searching and waiting and hoping that I would find the right place. And I had called a few different places, and for some reason, something just didn't feel right. And I'm the type of person that I just follow my intuition. So if my intuition is like, F it, let's do it, I just jump in, right? I'm very much somebody who I think with my heart and I follow what feels good, because at the end of the day, when I look back on my life, I want to do the things that feel really, really good to me and inspired. And, you know, whenever I would talk to the business owners of the coaching programs that I was kind of looking at and researching, just something didn't feel right. And then what I did instead, before I got my life coaching certification, is I actually ended up getting my Reiki certification, which was really, really cool. And my Reiki master here in Toronto, she's Better Days Now. You can find her on Instagram. She was licensed or certified in NLP, hypnotherapy, time techniques, all this really cool stuff. And she was telling me how there's places that will do it sort of all grouped together. And I was like, that sounds amazing. Like just getting it all together, you can see how they tie in. You can see how they work together. And so then I found the place where I went to, Transform Destiny. Their website was great. The webinar that I watched was great. The marketing was great. So I was like, this is somebody who really has a great sense, and I feel like I can learn a lot from them. So we learned NLP, and I was completely blown away. And if you don't know what NLP is, it's neuro-linguistic programming. And so it's really interesting because the first couple days, I was like, this is cool. I'm interested, blah, blah, blah. By day three, I was like a little bit pissed because I was like, why didn't we learn this in school? Like, what it shows you is essentially that you can't reprogram your mind, reprogram your thoughts, and you don't have to be a slave to the things that are holding you back in life. So if you're somebody who your whole life you haven't been confident, or you've been really, you know, shy, or you know, you're always worried that people are talking bad about you, and you know, you have a lot of negative self-talk, or maybe you're addicted to something, like I was addicted to coffee, and you just thought that, oh, it's too hard to quit, so I'm just stuck with this addiction. NLP can help you get rid of it like that. It can help you get rid of the feeling of overwhelm like that. It can help you get rid of literally feelings of sadness and anger like that, literally in like a 10-minute session or a 10-minute technique, which was incredible. So I ended up putting my hand up and volunteering for this really cool technique called the like to dislike technique. You can probably look it up and do some research on your own if you wanted. And so what the like to dislike technique does is it helps you take something that you really, really, really like, which for me was coffee, huge coffee drinker, and then shift it to the place in your brain where you store things that you don't like, which for me was like sugary lattes. I don't like stuff that's like really sugary or really sweet. And so it was really cool because for years I've been trying to give up coffee. And can you believe that right now I have no caffeine in my system and I'm like, and I'm like this all the time. So I've been trying to give up coffee for years. I just thought it was too hard. I can't do it. I tried a million things. It was way too hard. And the reason behind that is because I was trying to give up coffee with my conscious mind. Your conscious mind only controls pretty much 0.06% of your actions. And so if you're trying to change something about yourself, but you're only using your conscious mind, you're really just going to be struggling and forcing, and it's going to be hard and it's going to be painful. Your subconscious mind controls 99.94% of everything that you do. So when you can connect directly to your subconscious mind and shift those things around, which is what we did, changing your habits or your addictions or negative feelings is like that. So what they did was they shifted coffee from the place in my brain where I stored all the stuff that I like. They shifted it right to the place that where I store in my brain all the things that I don't like. And just like that, I quit coffee. I haven't drank a cup of coffee again, and it's amazing. And now, this is a weird sort of side thing that maybe I can talk about if you guys are interested in it, but now that I've quit coffee, I actually have more energy. I have more even energy levels during the day. I'm waking up at 6 a.m. every morning, not feeling tired. I'm going straight to the gym. I'm like wired all day, and I'm getting more stuff done. I'm focused. And actually, I went out for matcha green tea with one of my friends, Alyssa Coleman. I keep talking about her, but went out with coffee green tea with Alyssa, one of my friends, and didn't really even think about the fact that I had caffeine in it. And then the rest of the day, I was feeling kind of like icky. I'm like completely off caffeine, which is awesome. So those are the sorts of things that you can do using NLP if you're a coach, a life coach, a success coach, even if you maybe work in HR or people in culture or something at your business or at a big business and corporation, and you want a way where you can get through to people a lot quicker. And if there's somebody who's struggling with something, maybe a lack of confidence, or they're holding themselves back, or they belittle themselves, or they have a lack of self-love or something like that, you can use this NLP technique to just make quick shifts in people instead of having to work with them and talk about it and talk about the problem and pull things apart and put them back together. Right? It really just helps you fast forward to the problem. You can even use it to like have a boost of inspiration. So there's this really cool technique called anchoring, and you can literally use an anchor. You can create an anchor out of a song, out of a smell, out of a place on your body. So I could like anchor my shoulder, for example, to have more motivation. And by the way, guys, I put the link to the blog post all about this. So if you want to read more about my experience and where I did my coaching, you can head to the blog post and read all about it. But yeah, you can literally, if you're like, I want to have a button on me where I just magically feel good, or I just magically feel more motivated, or I am not missing that ex-boyfriend anymore, or whatever it is, you can anchor yourself for positive emotions. And guess what? When you're feeling better, you can focus more, you can get more done, you can be more in control of your emotions, you can be more in control of your productivity, you don't have FOMO, you're not constantly picking up your phone, wondering what everyone else on social media is doing, you become in more control of your life. So I'm obsessed with NLP. I'm so glad that I ended up taking the course there. And I'm going to be going back in March for the next level. So I'll be like a master NLP practitioner. I love you guys with all the heart. So cool. Thanks for joining. There's lots of people in this room. So what I also learned was hypnotherapy. So within the 7 days, they literally just like put so much information in your head. It was crazy. I also learned hypnotherapy. And so hypnotherapy isn't what I always thought it was and what you probably think it is, which is, you know, people going up on stage and dancing around like they're a monkey or something like that. It's completely different when you use it in the clinical sense. So what you can use hypnotherapy for is, again, if you want to change something about yourself, a habit or an addiction, or you want to feel better about something, or you want to create a new habit. Like I created a new habit of going to the gym every day and I feel amazing. You can use hypnotherapy to speak directly to your subconscious mind and change whatever it is. So I was actually introduced to the world of hypnotherapy through Marissa Peer. You can look her up. She's really cool. She's supposed to be Britain's number one therapist. She always says it in all of her videos. And she works with like celebrities and stuff like that. And so what I found out, as soon as people realized that I could do hypnotherapy, clients just started coming out of the woodwork. People just started coming out of the woodwork asking, can you hypnotize me for this? Can you hypnotize me for that? So I hypnotize people to help them quit smoking, to help them with their money mindset, to help them get the confidence to show up and do live streams and webinars and not be afraid of what people think. And you can literally have like a 20, 30 minute session with somebody. So if you're a coach, this is so powerful. You can have a very short session or experience with someone and help them change a habit or do the things that they know that they need to do to be more successful, to get in front of their audience, to grow their community, whatever it is that they need to do, those things that they used to have resistance to, you can use the power of hypnotherapy to make it something that seems like a natural habit to them, to make it something that just becomes very easy and effortless to them. So I definitely recommend the hypnotherapy. It's actually probably my favorite thing that I took out of it. I went for the NLP and then I was like, holy crap, this hypnotherapy stuff is absolutely amazing. So I've been doing lots of research on all the different things that you can use hypnosis for, and there's a lot of really cool stuff that you can use hypnosis for. We also learned success coaching and life coaching techniques, and I've been coaching for a while. So some of it was a refresher, but some of it was new, and it was really, really good at like the organization side of it, the planning side of it, the goal setting side of it. So I definitely recommend it. And now I know that there's a lot of health. I get a lot of questions from health coaches. I know there's a lot of health coaches watching. So I also wrote an article about one of the health coaching certifications that a lot of either my one-on-one clients have been in, people in my community, and I just see that a lot of leaders are associated with. So it's called IN. And if you just click the link, head to yessupply.co/blog and go to my two latest blog posts that are under the business session, section, the Yes Supply business section. You'll see them there, and I've linked them below if you're watching me on Facebook or YouTube. So head there, and you'll be able to read all about those. There's a free training course for you if you're somebody who's thinking of starting your health coaching business, or maybe you've been doing it for a while, but you're not able to find those clients, and so you want something that's going to make you stand out and give you a little bit more education, or also help you maybe specialize in something if you're just like a broad health coach and you want to find that little area where you know you can really, really help people and you can stand out. So if you have any questions at all, the best place to do it is actually to head to the blog post and leave a comment on the blog post, because I'll just check those and answer if you guys have any questions for me, or you can send me a message, and I love hearing from you. I've actually got a lot of messages from people in the last few days who are telling me that they're quitting their jobs and that the quotes that I'm putting up or the live streams that I'm putting up or whatever are really inspiring them and helping them and support them, which is really, really cool for me. It totally motivates me to keep doing what I'm doing and helping you guys figure out what your yes is, what it is that you want to create in this world, giving you that feeling of empowerment and independence to go out there and create it, because I really do believe in you. I know that if you want to start your own business, or you just want to blaze your own trail, you want to do something where you can use your own creativity and get out there and really just take this one life that we have and make the most of it, you can do it. If you have that desire inside of you to make something amazing, there's a reason that you have that desire, and it's because it's what you're meant to do in this world. So I 100% believe in you. If you have any questions, shoot me a message. I also have a really great free training for anybody who wants to start a business. It's at yessupply.co/5C. It's a free 5-day training. It's absolutely incredible. It has some of my favorite tools and software that I use to run my business and that I help my clients use as well. So I think you'll absolutely love it. But I love you guys so much. Thanks for hanging out with me, and hope you have an amazing rest of your week, and only take yes for an answer. Bye, guys.